I'm going to be well all my life. Some folks are going to tell you, them also attending the Baptist, but Methodists and everybody else tell you, no, honey, you got to be sick. You got to be poor. You're going to get in the kingdom. Things we've been fed.
You sure it was my classmates last week said, nothing's wrong with y'all?
Yeah.
You don't have, not even high blood pressure.
No. Not even high blood pressure. No. So, okay. At the bottom of page 3, things, environment. Your environment can mess with your believing. Your environment. All the words, good, wholesome, erroneous, negative, corrupt, mean, vulgar, hostile, discouraging, frustrating, spoken by people you knew and those who didn't know, and those you didn't know that were what, around you. They all these kind of things is going to shape you. The devil is throwing them out there. I say a lot of times when I'm preaching that there's different sounds in the world. And whatever sound that you tune into, that's the sound, you know. Well, I'm going by a negative drum beat. Can't amount to nothing, can't do nothing. Can't get a good job. Those are all the sound, the beats is out there. Or you can lean over the other ear and hear something that's saying quite positive things. You can be whatever you can. And then you gotta choose which way am I going. Because one of them you're gonna have to line up with. Lord, we're talking about faith for a minute here. See about some scriptures here. We got any scriptures in here? Good. I'm over on page 4. It says, be that not only all things who impact you with words, but also their lifestyles. Oh man, this is tough here. Lifestyles. Well, let's see. If you live in a home, I got neighbors. How many of you have ever had neighbors that fuss and fight like cats and dogs? Mm-hmm. You ever had seen anybody like that? So Sibba says you don't. You never live by nobody. You don't know how fortunate you are. They come out of there fighting like cats and dogs, man. Wow, cussing, raising all kinds of them. And if you like that as a kid, or talking about one of my classmates, one of his guy's ex-girlfriends, 40 years later now, last week, she was talking about how this guy, I always thought this guy Mike was a good guy, good friend of mine, he run around everything. She said, yeah, he quit me for her, but she said, but he used to throw me up against the lockers and choke my neck like that. And I said, Mike was like that. I said, why don't you? Because the fellas we hung out with, none of us do nothing like that. We can talk about, yeah, I slapped around, get my weight out of it. Where do you get that kind of? He had to learn it from somewhere, didn't he? Mm-hmm. Papa saw his dad treat his mom like that. Uncle treat his wife like that. Something. Maybe a neighbor. I said, well, I thought we was cool, you know. My bell-bottom jeans was enough for me to catch it and get out of the way. She said, yeah, I fell up, choked her, threw her against lockers and stuff. So, an environment that we're raised around will make out of that kind of lifestyle. We do it. You're raised around people who are thieves, who, you know, want to do the shortcut, beat the system all the time, not thinking about any other way of making it, but then they know how to beat the system very well, then you could adapt into that real good yourself. That has an effect. Shortcuts, I call it. Take the shortcuts. Okay. And experiences, and I don't want to forget this one, repetitious information. Now, repetitious information can work for you or can work against you. And this is why the Word of God has to be, like Joshua says, meditated. Make it a commercial in your mind over and over and over again. And I know right now I can play a game and say, Winston tastes good like a I'm gonna finish that out. How come y'all, when was the last time you saw that commercial? Been years.
A little dab of good.
A little dab, but it's a real cream on it. Repetitive information going into, you know. So the child of God has a lot to fight off when he gets into the arena of faith. But Jesus is telling us that in the arena of faith, the way that you win is that you believe what you were saying, and you say it constantly, 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 and have it reaffirmed over and over and over again. Your name is no longer Abram. Your name is no longer Abram. Huh? What is my name? Your name is now Abraham, father of many, father of many. What? So Abram, anytime you, your name is not Abram, it's Abraham. Anytime you introduce yourself to somebody, you are how old? 75. I'm the father of a whole lot of kids.
You don't see any yet.
And then look at you. This man is 75 years old. We know you ain't yet. What are you talking about? Sister Sylvia again, call me short. You talking as crazy as you can be. You're just a crazy talking old woman. It's a crazy talking old man. Noah, what are you doing, Noah? I'm building an ark. What for, Noah? For something that has never happened before. But what is that, Noah? Rain. Noah, you're crazy. But it says in Hebrew 11 that he rebuked the whole world by his actions, and that demonstrated he got into the hall of faith. Noah, what are you doing? I'm building up for what? Not like that ever happened before. Okay, so that's how you have to repeat it, Abraham, everywhere I go. My name is Abraham, father of me. You ain't got nothing one. What's your name? John Dorsey, billionaire. The guy said, listen, check his address. We'll see where you live. He gave a North Tulsa address. So that guy is crazy he can be. Next time you come here, I'm going to tell him he's crazy. You ain't no billionaire. You live over there in North Tulsa. How do you think you're a billionaire? What's your name again? John Dorsey, billionaire. Tycoon. You got to keep it going, keep it going. Said, why you say that? Because the Lord has already told me in my heart, and I believe it. So that's faith. Sometimes it makes you seem like you are a nutcase, but you got to keep talking if you want results. And you've got to put, we don't have time to talk about the actions, but the actions will bring you. Once you believe it, put the action behind it. But you got to put the action behind the right information.
Hope y'all got a little something out of that.